friends. So, this is our English language class. Today, we'll start a new chapter, a new story. It is named as Dear Mrs. Naidu. So, the name of the story, Dear Mrs. Naidu. It is actually a letter written by a 12-year-old girl to someone she is inspired by. And who is a popular personality too. This part is taken from the book Dear Mrs. Naidu. In 2013, it was written by Mathangi Subramanian. Remember the name of the author? Mathangi Subramanian, an Indian writer and educator. Here, the 12-year-old girl who wrote this letter, named as Sarojini, she lived in the slum area of Bangalore. Now it is called Bengaluru, with her mother, who is a maid. Maid is a female domestic servant, is called maid. The girl Sarojini became very fond of Mrs. Sarojini Naidu as she read a book on her. That book was given by her teacher Bimala Madam. The childhood story of Mrs. Naidu attracted her very much. Now, I will tell you about the famous personality, Mrs. Sarojini Naidu. She was an Indian political activist and poet before independence. She was an important figure in Indian struggle for freedom. For her beautiful poetry writings, she was given the title Nightingale of India. She was called as Nightingale of India. Now, come to the story. One day, when a new teacher in the school of that girl Sarojini, the teacher name of the teacher was Annie Miss, assigned to write a letter to a person. Sarojini preferred to write to Mrs. Naidu, her favorite personality. She chose to write her because she could share, confess and express her thoughts honestly and freely with her. So now I'm going to read the story. So the name of the story is Dear Mrs. Naidu. Okay? So here the sentences written here is, let us now read a letter written by a 12-year-old girl to someone she is inspired by. Someone popular, someone unusual. So the girl is, 12-year-old girl is Sarojini, the little girl, and the person, the famous personality was Mrs. Sarojini Naidu. Both of their first name is Sam. And date of the letter, June 10, 2013. Dear Mrs. Naidu, I guess you are wondering why I am writing you this letter. Honestly, Mrs. Naidu, so am I. Amma says I am not allowed to speak to strangers. You would think that also meant that I shouldn't write to them. But since this is a school assignment, she says it's okay. Here is a tip, Mrs. Naidu. If you ever want adults to let you do something, just tell them it is a school assignment. They will 100% agree to it every time. So here Amma is Sarojini's mother, who works as a housemaid. Usually, parents not allowed their kids to speak or write to any unknown person, isn't it? You know it very well. You did that many times. Isn't it that to get permission of your parent, you told them, "Je, miss, ya teacher ne aise ye karne ke liye boli thi." Don't that? Yes, I know it very well. Maybe I should start from the beginning. The beginning was last week. Last week, I started class 6. And I met our new teacher, Annie Miss, who is not like any teacher I have had before. For example, Anime says she doesn't think school should be about memorizing things and saying them back. She says memorizing things and saying them back makes Shiva a parrot, not a person. She says she wants us to grow our brains and our hearts. So, Animes, the new teacher, impressed Sarojini very much. She says study is not about only memorizing and saying them back. It is to know with our brain and heart. When she said that, I wanted to ask how our hearts will help us pass our exams and college and get a job and buy a house with a proper roof and maybe even a garden, which are all the reasons why we go to school. But I didn't. You know how adults are, Mrs. Naidu. They don't like questions. Actually, usually, we always thought that we study to live a better life, to buy houses, to get a better job, to get much more wealth, isn't it? So, even though it was only the first week of school, Miss gave us an assignment. Miss says that now that we are in sixth standard, it is time for us to be serious. Every teacher says this every year, but none of them ever gave us assignments during the first week of school. So Animes might mean it. The assignment is to write letters to someone we would like to get to know better. She said that we could pick anyone as long as we explain it why. Actually, Animes gave them an assignment on their first week in school. That was to write letters to someone, and the little girl Sarojini chose to write Mrs. Sarojini Naidu. As you have probably concluded, Mrs. Naidu, I picked you. This is the first time I have said. Firstly, she wrote said, then he crossed it, and right here written the words concluded. It's an English word that means figured out based on clues and evidence. I learned it too by reading detective stories, even though our English miss says they are useless rags. I think this proves, she wrote before, I think this proves, then cross it. And right here, I conclude that she is wrong. I understand if you find this confusing, Mrs. Naidu. After all, you and I don't have much in common. For one thing, I am alive and you are well. You are not. So, here we can watch that the girl read detective stories very much. And the important point here is that the girl write to a person who is not alive. You know, Sarojini Naidu died in the year 1949. Okay? Now, I'm sorry if that was rude, but I have never written to a, firstly wrote, dead, deceased, passed on. Then he cross it and write historical person before. So I don't really know the polite way to say it. Here's another difference between us. When you were 12, which is how old I am now, you wrote a poem that was thousands of lines long and it was in English. I don't think I could write that many lines in any language, definitely not in English. So, there are many differences between these two Sarojini, the young girl Sarojini and Mrs. Naidu. The first point, that she is alive, that the little girl is alive and Mrs. Naidu is not. And next, the second point, at the age of 12, Mrs. Naidu wrote a long poem, but the little girl, she can't do it. Okay? Also, when you were 12, you topped the Madras University matriculation exam. I topped our class 5 exams, but I don't think I could top a college exam even if I studied really, really hard. The third point is, at the age of 12, Mrs. Naidu topped matriculation exam, but the girl topped class 5 exam only. You fought, next, what she wrote, you fought for India's freedom and won. I have never fought for anything. If I did, I'm not sure if I would win, especially if I was fighting against the Britishers, who have lots of spies and detectives and things that I don't think we have in India. And the fourth point is, Sarojini Naidu fought for India's freedom, we all know it. And the girl never fought for anything. She even couldn't thought about India before independence. So, that's all for today. Okay, I will read the rest of this story in our next class. Okay, so till then, bye.